Hello friends, in this video, this is cyclo addition part 2. For part 1 and other parts of cyclo addition reaction, which is a type of pericyclic reaction, the link will be over here. Three important factors that we have to consider. This is the electron, that is 2 plus 2 or 4 plus 2 pi electrons, nature of orbitals, that is pi or sigma, and then the stereochemistry, which is important, superficial or it is syn or antra addition. Now this question, it is from CSIR net, June 2011. The concerted photochemical reactions between two olefins leading to cyclobutane. Now cyclobutane means there will be two ethene molecules that are participating, as I discussed in the previous part 1 video. This double one falls here and this double one falls here. Later, what is the condition that is given? Photochemical, that is H nu. So this will lead to the formation of a cyclobutane ring. Now we have to check which option is this right. Now the things that we need to consider, we have to consider the orbitals. Orbital diagram for ethene. For ethene, we are having only two energy level. Here we are having both phases on top, and the next one is one phase on top, the other phase, the positive phase, this is down. Okay, so these are called as pi orbitals for ethene. Only for ethene it is pi orbital. For 1,3-butadiene or 1,3,5-hexadiene, they are sigma. So in this case, both are pi. This is pi star. This is pi and this is pi star, because it is anti-bonding. So if there is sigma bond that is present, you can cancel it out. So option C and D cancels out, because we are having sigma orbital over here, but we don't have sigma orbital for the ethene. Now the next condition, it is H nu. Another important factor is, in cycloaddition reaction, we need homo LUMO interaction. HOMO means highest occupied molecular orbital, and in LUMO it is lowest unoccupied molecular orbital. Now when you consider photochemical conditions, just remember, in photochemical condition, the electron over here, we are having two electrons for ethene. The one electron gets excited to the next level and this becomes the HOMO for this ethene molecule. If you consider one ethene molecule, this is the HOMO, which is the highest occupied molecular orbital. Now what happens when there is photochemical condition? If there are many ethene molecules, only few will go excitation. The rest, they remain to ground state. If they remain to ground state, I'm drawing this part again. If they remain to ground state, both the electrons are down, and this is the HOMO for them. But this becomes a new LUMO for many of the ethene molecule. Why many? Because in photochemical condition, very few ethene molecules, they will go excitation, and very few ethene molecule will have this HOMO. And many of them will have this as the LUMO. Since we are interested only in HOMO-LUMO interaction, so we are having this as the HOMO only in the photochemical state. So I am drawing the HOMO. We are interested only in the HOMO orbital. We are not interested in this. So how is the HOMO looking? Highest occupied molecular orbital, positive phase here, and the positive phase here. Okay, so I'm going to dedicate this part. Now what happens to the LUMO here? What is the LUMO for many of the ethene molecule? This is the LUMO. So how it looks? One phase is above, one phase is below. So I'll draw it here for convenience purpose. I'll draw it here and this part here. So we are having this part here and one phase above. So what will happen now? This phase, and this phase they are matching, so they will form a bond. Now what happens here in this case? And in this case, the positive phases, these phases are same and they will form a bond, leading to the formation of this product. So we are having pi orbitals. Yes, both the conditions are matching. How many electrons? Both are 2, 2 and 2 here. So yes, it is 2 and 2, 2 plus 2. So at the moment, A and B looks the correct answer. Now the next thing is, here we are having S. S means suprafacial, and this A means antrafacial. And here we are having suprafacial, suprafacial. Both the cases here it is suprafacial, here it is suprafacial and antrafacial. Now what is suprafacial? Now suprafacial means when the same phases they come in contact. When the same phases they come in contact, they are called as suprafacial. Now if in case this phase was down and this phase was above, so what would have happened? The phases over here, they wouldn't have matched, and when they don't match, they are called as antrafacial. The phases are matching, so it is suprafacial. So option B becomes the right choice, since we are having pi orbital, the electrons are two, same phases are meeting each other, so both are suprafacial. So option B, it is the right choice.